Welcome to our YouTube channel. Today I'm going to recap a movie titled The Vault, or Way Down, which is a Spanish action thriller movie. So let's get into the movie. The movie begins with a scene in which we see a destroyed ship and we see a box having written Sic Parvis on it. In the next scene, we see two divers who are taking the stuff out of the ocean. Then we see a man named Walter who asks them about that box. There were two men down in the ocean. One was named James, who goes inside the broken ship and brings out the box. Walter gets very excited and shares a drink with James when he comes out. All of a sudden, Spain custom police arrives there and asks them to raise their hands. Then the scene shifts to court, where the judges consider Walter's act as piracy and take the whole stuff under government custody. We see Margaret there. Later, Walter tells Margaret that it was not an illegal act and asks her to help him, but she denies doing so and tells him that it's impossible for her to do. Then we see all of the stuff being transferred to a vault under strict security. After that, the scene shifts to Cambridge University, where we see a boy named Tom. Many multinational companies come to meet him and offer him high-paying jobs, but he rejects them all, saying that their interests do not match. In the next scene, we see Tom sitting with his dad, who is worried about him as he rejected all of the job offers. Tom says that he doesn't like to be like him, and he directly told them about his interest. During this, Tom gets a message from an unknown number asking him to meet the unknown person. He offers Tom a lifetime opportunity, after which Tom leaves the table saying he is going to get fresh air. On the way, a man makes him wear a jacket from which he finds a coin and a letter telling him about the meeting. Tom then reaches a party where he meets Lorraine, who takes him with her. She meets a man there and takes out his wallet while Tom sees all this. Tom asks her why did she do it, and he doesn't want to get involved in this all. Lorraine asks him to check his pockets, and Tom finds the wallet inside his pocket. Lorraine then gives him two options. Either he can give the wallet back to the person and be a good citizen, or he can follow her. Tom goes with her to a restaurant where she asks him to wait. Then Walter comes to meet him and introduces himself, showing him his card. He says that he needs Tom to open the most secure vault in the world. Tom argues that he is an engineer and can't do this. Walter then tells him about the mystery of engineering, which provokes curiosity in Tom. Walter then leaves, giving him tickets to Madrid and saying his future is calling him. Tom goes to his apartment and starts searching for the mystery of engineering, then calls his dad, telling him he is going out for a while and goes to Madrid, where Lorraine comes to pick him up. She takes him to the place where Walter with other crew members are present. Walter introduces Tom as the mastermind of their plan to James, Klaus, and Simon. After that, Klaus was facing some issues connecting to the cameras of the building. Tom gives him the solution, on which everyone is impressed by his genius. Lorraine then takes him to his room and says he can go if he wants. Then we see Walter and Tom sitting in a restaurant. Walter asks Tom about Francis Drake, who was a famous sailor. Walter tells him that he used to work on his own, on which Tom says he was a pirate. Walter then tells him that Francis Drake has hidden a treasure somewhere, and its location was imprinted on three coins. Walter tells him that he spent 30 years searching for them. These coins are kept in the vault in the Bank of Spain. Walter says that he is not doing this for money, and he has a lot of that. Rather, he is doing it for his passion. Tom is very impressed by him. Next, Walter and his crew explain the whole plan to Tom and show him some pictures of the interior of the vault. They inform him about Mr. Gustavo Medina, in charge of security in the Bank of Spain. They tell him that the vault works on a certain mechanism that will close it automatically, and then there will be no way in or out. Walter tells him that he is here to identify this mechanism. Walter then tells that they are going inside the Bank of Spain tomorrow for stage one. Simon calls the security guard and tells him that they'll come tomorrow for the job while getting a duplicate sanitary car ready. After that, Walter and James get into an argument. Klaus then tells Tom and Simon that the Bank of Spain is using Interpol facial recognition and James can't go as he has worked in special forces. Walter asks him to teach the magnetometer and James says he can't do it in one night. Tom says that he will go instead of James. Tom and Simon go to the Bank of Spain. Simon keeps the guard busy in football talks while checking and he lets them go in without any doubts. Then we see Lorraine, who goes inside the bank as Valentine to check the paintings. There she meets Mr. Gustavo, and she cleverly manages to get his fingerprints on a cup of coffee. Then we see Mr. Gustavo going to keep an eye on the cameras. Simon passes by him to enter the server room. Klaus hacks the cameras, and Simon connects the device to the server, allowing them to control all cameras. Then an officer takes Lorraine to the chairman's office. There, Klaus plays his recording in a loop, checking the painting while she scans the key that was required to open the vault. Then Chairman comes in, and Klaus tells her if she doesn't get back in position within 20 seconds, the plan will be ruined. She deals with the situation smartly, and on the other hand, Tom enters the meeting room where he fixes the magnetometer over the vault to know its structure. All of a sudden, the officials arrive there, and James asks to abort the mission, but Walter tells him that Tom will manage to do it. The magnetometer blocks at 95%, while James asks Klaus to hack the alarms. Before anyone could spot Tom, the security alarms blow and everyone runs from there. Gustavo asks the soldiers to surround the bank, and no one will leave or enter the bank, while Lorraine, who is scanning the second key, leaves the room with the key in her hand and the case being opened. Walter asks Simon to receive the key, but he says he can't do this. Finally, Tom manages to catch the key and get back to the room to close the case. A quick reminder, before we continue our review of this movie, if you've enjoyed the video so far, consider subscribing, as we frequently upload such informative and entertaining videos. Let's continue. A police officer arrives there, and Tom tells her he couldn't hear the alarms due to his earbuds. Tom then discusses the structure of the vault with them, and after a while, he understands the mechanism of the vault's action. He tells them that it works on weight. Anything put over the weight limit will activate its security system. Then we see Gustavo with bank's authorities. Gustavo asks them to shift the crowd from Celeb Square to somewhere else, as it causes the security cameras to focus on the crowd instead of the bank, but they deny doing so. After that, we see Simon and James under the vault to determine its structure under the building, and they get disappointed. They tell Walter that they can't open the vault from down, as it will take 15 days, or if they attack it heavily, it will activate the alarms. Walter gets angry, and everyone leaves disappointingly. On the semi-final evening, Walter observes that all of the cameras were directed to the crowd. He calls his crew and tells them that if Spain manages to qualify for the final, they'll do their job from the upside, and they'll have 105 minutes to do it. Now everything depends on the match. Tom talks to Walter that he has not done his work yet and the final is 4 days away, but Walter tells him that he can do it and he has belief in him. Spain qualifies for the final and they get excited. Tom spends many sleepless nights to find the solution, and one day Lorraine comes to ask him for rest. Then she sees her sketch with other paper while Tom falls asleep. Then she goes to Walter and tells him that these things are stressing him and he is only a college kid. Walter asks her if it's the reason or something else, and Lorraine gets silent. The next day, she takes Tom with her to a bar, where she tells her about her past and her mom and dad. Tom sees the bartender using nitrogen to cool the drinks. Then he goes and shows them an example of nitrogen messing with the weight system. Then he asks them that he'll need 500 liters of nitrogen to freeze the system of the vault. But James tells him this will make a person less in their crew to do the job. Firstly, Walter says to go, but Tom tells them he'll go inside with James and Lorraine, while Simon will freeze the system. Then they start the preparations for the job. Klaus prepares a copy of the fingerprint and keys required to enter the vault, while Walter goes to get the exact engraved copies of coins they are going to steal. After that, they all share drinks, sharing their regrets according to tradition. On the day of the final, Gustavo takes the control of the building. James, Tom, and Lorraine manage to enter the building through the roof while Simon goes to freeze the weight system. Klaus and Walter keep an eye on them through cameras and guide them. During their journey to reach the vault, Tom slows them and half of the time remains for them to complete the task. On the other hand, Gustavo was in the control room and gets angry with workers talking about football. Finally, James and his crew reach the vault and Klaus cracks the code for them. Then, Simon freezes the system and they enter the vault. After entering the vault, they find the coins, but the nitrogen starts melting quickly. On the other hand, Gustavo finds a pigeon that enters through the roof, and he asks all units to go to the vault. Walter tells them to surrender, but Tom says there will be some other way. During this all, James betrays them and tells Walter he is working for his country as Margaret told him. Water starts to fill up in the vault, while James leaves them as he can swim against the water flow. Tom and Lorraine start to drown in water, and Gustavo gets the control of cameras. Tom asks Simon to put the nitrogen cylinders on the weight to dodge it. Simon puts the weight, but it doesn't help. Then he puts on his father's radio, which helps to stop the water flow. It seems they both have died. Walter gets disappointed. Then Gustavo with the soldiers arrives there and finds no one in the vault. Gustavo finds traces of them and eventually finds them. Lorraine and Tom reach a room with no cameras and Walter asks them to stay there while they both run. After being chased by Gustavo, they manage to get into the crowd through a window. Gustavo tries to shoot them, but is stopped as there were many people there. He sends soldiers to chase them. They both change their clothes while running and stand at one point and kiss each other. The soldiers pass nearby them without identifying them. Then they all get very happy. After that, Walter meets Margaret and tells her that she used him while he considered her a friend. She says the country is above all. Then Walter leaves, saying friends and family are above everything. Then she goes to where James was present and traces the location. Then she comes to know that they changed the coins. Then the scene shifts to Walter and his crew, who were enjoying, and Tom asks how did they do it. Lorraine tells him the way she put the wallet in his pocket. Walter then traces the location from real coins, and we see Lorraine and the Bank of England, indicating their next salvage, and the movie ends here. If you have already watched this movie, share your reviews with us in the comments below. Before you go, make sure to like this video and share it with your friends who are into drama, comedy, and crime fiction movies. Thank you for watching.